Hi everyone, Kelly here. Welcome to day 20 of the art challenges for October. Mine is Squaretober, where I take a 4x4 inch piece of watercolor paper, make a small piece of art on it, and upload the video every day in October. Today, I'm gonna work on a piece of art that I did earlier in the challenge. I didn't upload it, because it was yet another mandala. And this is not the mandala challenge after all. But today I looked at it and I have been so inspired by the different techniques that I've been playing with watercolor that I looked at this today and I said, okay, today I'm using this that I'd already half started. I can do something with this. And there's a point to that story. I can't tell you how many pieces of line art that I've done, and I've literally thrown it away thinking it was too repetitive. I wasn't excited about it. I didn't want to do anything with it. And later on, I thought of a technique or something that would have at least, at the very least, been something to experiment on with it. And so this time I was at least self-aware enough that I might want to reuse it or use it for something later on, and I kept it. And I started getting really excited about some new techniques with watercolor. Actually, they may not be new techniques. Well, they're not new techniques. Other people have obviously used them, but maybe ones that I hadn't used in this particular way. You know how we usually want to get the most smooth, perfect, even washes with watercolor? Well, this time I wanted to mix color in a dappled way so that it left a very uneven but cool looking textural background or wash. And I was actually so excited when I started this that you know what I did? I put pink in the background. I didn't want pink. I wanted something really neutral for the background. And so to neutralize it, I put in sap green. Well, magenta is kind of a purplish red, and sap green is kind of a yellowish green. So they're opposites, more or less, on the color wheel. And that's one way you can neutralize or tame down something that is very overly vibrant, and depending on how neutral you want it, how much that depends on how much of its opposite you want to put in there. And I really could have made it more and more green, which is what I did in the end. And oops, I forgot to record this part, but fortunately, it's the same technique is used throughout this entire painting, aside from a few smaller sections of the painting. So basically you put down one wash and a very pale wash, and then you drop in other colors and watch the magic of how this just goes in there. It's just gorgeous. And you can also go back and add more. So what I've added, I started out with transparent orange, and then I added magenta, and then I added nickel yellow azo. And I love the way that turned out so much. There's a juxtaposition, or I don't know, there's something really beautiful about hot pink and hot orange put together. They're vibrant, but maybe because they're so close on the color wheel, they don't fight with each other. If anything, they seem to make each other just that much more vibrant. Okay, and then to go along in the background, I put some more sap green, but I mixed it with someone in the comments. I'm sorry, I can't remember who just at this very instant. But somebody said, there's nothing better than palette mud. Well, I mixed the palette mud with this sap green, and I put another layer of paint over that background section. And then I used Dioxazine Violet and Cerulean Blue on those. I don't know what you call those. I don't know my flower anatomy very well. They're not stamens. I don't know. But they're like little inside petals. I don't know what those are called. But I made those Dioxazine Purple with Cerulean Blue with Dioxazine Purple again. And I think that they are just the right amount of opposite, or, well, not really opposite, but yeah, kind of opposite to that yellow, that sort of saffron yellow back there. That they provide an accent, but it's not like they're fighting. You know, I think sometimes when you use opposites, it's better to use less of the accent. It becomes more of an accent color, right? And anyway, I like the way that worked out. Then I used, on the next four petals, I used Nickel Yellow Azo. I dropped in Transparent Orange. And then I dropped in more Nickel Yellow Azo because I wanted this part to be more yellow, maybe come forward just a little bit more. And you may notice each petal isn't the same. And that's okay. That's the, you know, it's not matchy-matchy, same-same. And that's part of the charm of this kind of technique that I wanted to experiment. It almost looks like stained glass. If only I knew how to make stained glass windows or even small stained glass pieces for, I don't know, adornments in, what are those transom windows that go above doorways? Anyway, I don't know. It's something I would like to someday try. For now, I'll have to be content with making watercolor stained glass. Okay, now I'm taking my Coro or Fine Tech. It's really the same thing, you guys. I'm taking, I think it's even made by the same company. I'm taking gold. I'm not sure which gold it is. It's just like the most generic of the golds that you can use. And yeah, I'm just painting the fleur-de-lis. Can you tell that I like fleur-de-lis? I mean, they're almost in every, well, not in every. That's a huge exaggeration, but they're in a lot of my artwork. I'm not even French, but I do love a beautiful fleur-de-lis. And I like it. I like it embellished with gold. And you have to do more than one layer. And I've tried different brands. The Fine Tech seems to work the best for me. I even tried making my own out of real gold. And I've tried the Kramer, which is beautiful and it does go on very smoothly, but sometimes they're out of it and it takes forever to get to me and I lose patience with that. The Fine Tech and Coro are fine. You just have to use more than one layer. And I decided that these other little pieces needed to be gilded as well. I don't know what they are. I think some of them are stamens, but they needed to be gilded. And this piece went from a really blah, I might as well trash it feeling to something that I like very, very much. In fact, it might be my personal favorite. So don't throw away your old art that you could maybe rehab or do something else with. Anyway, you guys, have a great night. I'll see you tomorrow and happy creating.